interested in the ways that flowers can mediate so many different kinds of interactions. They're this resource. They're colorful. They smell. They have nectar and pollen. They're kind of this beacon that can interact with so many different kinds of organisms in so many different ways, which I think is really fascinating. But in the last decade or so, we've been really focusing on the ways that flowers could play roles in disease transmission.
Many of us have heard of, like, oh, the bees are in danger, oh, the bees are in decline, and many species are in trouble.
It's a combination of factors. If there was one simple thing we could do to save the bees, we would have done it already. We would have figured it out. But it's a combination of habitat loss, so converting sort of diverse areas into houses or residential areas or monoculture type agriculture.
Lack of floral resources, pesticides, and pathogens, which is mostly what we study in this lab.
My research is focusing on how different flowers are able to cause a variation in how diseases are being transmitted among the pollinators. And the focus is to work on about 25 different plant species that are native to this area and commonly grown by the farmers that are in this area.
Lynn Adler and her colleagues made this amazing discovery a few years ago that whenever bees are fed sunflower pollen, they do not become infected with one species of pathogen that affects their gut. And we've also followed up with other studies screening other species in the same family, in the same sunflower family, and we're finding that it's not just sunflower. Other members in the same family also provide this medicinal effect.
It looks like it might be something about the spikiness of the pollen rather than the chemistry. We've been interested in the role that flowers might play, not only as resources that might feed bees, but also help them fight off disease, but also as just sites where disease transmission can occur.
We applied for a large National Science Foundation grant that was evaluating the benefits to the community.
And try to get more of a sense of kind of what plantings really promote bee health so that people can be using their resources most effectively.
Different bees have preferences. Some like small white flowers, some of them like large blue flowers. We want all of them to be included in the mix. We were awarded the grant, which began this year.
Healthy bees equals nutritious food, lots of fruits and vegetables.
Healthy bees means a healthy ecosystem, means diversity of food, balanced diets for both the bees and for us.